Well, have you ever thought about going electric? These days, we're seeing a lot more electric vehicles on the road, and for good reason. Not only are they helping the environment, but they're also saving drivers money and giving them extra perks. Here to tell us about some of the new laws benefiting electric vehicle owners is Jose Plasencia with AAA. Jose, how are you? Good morning
and
welcome.
I'm doing well. Thank you for having us on again, Alex.
Oh, sure, of course. All right, at the beginning of the year, some new laws went into effect for electric cars. Go ahead and tell us what those are in a nutshell.
Okay, so starting January 1st, 2012, a new clean air vehicle sticker is available to a limited number of qualified plug-in hybrid electric vehicles.
Okay. Why only a limited number?
Well, there's a limited number of 40,000 that the California legislature has approved. That means that the first 40,000 who get the new clean air vehicles are eligible for one of two different stickers that are going to be coming out.
Okay, so those the two new stickers are colors green and white.
And white, yeah.
But we know of the yellow ones. Those are null and void now, the yellow ones.
Correct, correct. So back in 2006, the California legislature said, hey, let's encourage people to get new plug-in electric vehicles. Now that sticker is null and void, and that happened July 1st, 2011.
Okay. What are the benefits of owning one of these stickers?
Well, the benefits of owning one of these stickers is that you get to drive in the carpool lane in areas where they have carpools, and that's to encourage you to purchase the vehicle and also help save the air here in the valley.
Okay, so now we don't have a lot of those kind of lanes here, obviously, but a lot of us do drive to San Francisco a lot,
yes.
LA, those metro
yes.
areas.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us the difference between a plug-in vehicle, a hybrid vehicle,
mm-hmm.
and an
mm-hmm.
electric vehicle. I mean,
okay.
a lot of
okay.
people think they're the same, and technically they are, but
yes,
not
they are.
So much.
Well, the new technology that's available now and what the stickers are available for are basically vehicles that have a partial to zero emissions into the air. Now, the difference between a plug-in hybrid electric vehicle that was available a few years ago and today is that engine ran on both gas and also electricity. Now, the new vehicles that we're promoting here for these stickers are going to be about 100% battery powered or natural gas powered.
Do you think that people are a little bit reluctant to drive these vehicles because maybe it's something we're not used to? I mean, a lot of us rely on gas. We're used to getting gas. I mean, these sound a little too good to be true. You just plug them in, right? Basically, you charge them all night?
Well, you charge them, and the greatest benefit of these is that, A, you don't have to spend that money that hurts you most in your wallet, number one, and the other residual benefit is that you're going to help clean the air of these powerful emissions that, as you know, in the Central Valley, have an impact on both you and me, our children, our babies.
Boy, it's awful.
It is.
Yeah, the air.
It is, yeah.
All right, we have a list of some of these vehicles that are eligible right now. And a lot of these are cars that we've heard of. Obviously, the Chevy Volt is one of them.
Mm-hmm.
And then the Ford Focus electric. What is that? ZEV?
That's zero emission vehicle. That's an acronym. That's what those are for.
Okay, I'm naive about this. Okay, let's see. The Honda Civic.
Yes. Runs on natural gas.
Gotcha. Uh-huh. And the Mercedes. Mercedes has come up with a.
Mercedes has an amazing vehicle called the F Cell, and that one actually runs on hydrogen, which is a zero emission vehicle.
I think I missed the Nissan Leaf electric vehicle as well.
Personally, I haven't seen it yet.
It sounds nice. It sounds nice. Amanda, which one do you have? A Nissan Altima hybrid. Now, would that be eligible? Would she have an Altima?
Well, she was eligible a few years ago, but as I said, today the encouragement is to purchase one of these cars.
Got it.
Because they have zero emissions in the air. The
zero
one that she
emissions.
Has is both a combustible engine run on gas and electricity.
Okay, got it. Also, Mitsubishi is come up with their zero emission vehicle. The Toyota Prius, the plug-in hybrid. And for a list of these cars, you can also go to the DMV website, which is dmv.ca.gov.
Yes.
Okay, so really, we're being encouraged to purchase these vehicles. It's good for us, good for the environment. And also another good thing you're having there is a charity event at AAA.
Boy.
Let's talk about that.
Yeah, what an exciting event. This year, AAA of Northern California and the San Francisco Giants are partnering up to help the Junior Giants Round the Bases Reading Program.
Okay. And what kind of program is that? It's a reading program for kids?
It's a reading program for the players of these Junior Giants leagues that are around the area. And they actually may not have the opportunity for education or literacy programs. And essentially the way it works is when you call in or come into your local AAA office and get a homeowner's or auto quote, we will donate $5 to the Junior Giants Round the Bases
Just
Reading
by getting
program.
A quote?
Just by getting a quote.
Okay.
Come
oh,
on
that's
in.
That's easy enough.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, and remember that donation will help local communities and get us closer to raising that $50,000. That's your goal for
yes.
the Junior Giants Round the Bases Reading Program. Another thing is when you do get the insurance mm-hmm. quote, you will get a chance to win a pair of tickets.
Yes.
To see the world-famous San Francisco Giants in San Francisco.
Yes, we have up to 80 of these tickets. Come on in, get a quote. As a matter of fact, we're going to have a tailgate party on April 12th in the Clovis office of AAA, and
wow.
on April 4th in the Fresno office of AAA, we're going to have free food, fun. You don't need to be a member. Just come on in, get a quote. We'll donate $5 to the Junior Giants Reading Program, and you'll get a chance to win some tickets to the world-famous San Francisco Giants.
There you go. I love how you say that, Jose. You must be a fan.
Yes, I am.
All right. Well, it sounds like a great, great, great time. That's happening when again?
But the Fresno office of AAA on April 4th.
April 4th.
And the Clovis office of AAA on April 12th.
There you go. Go to AAA.com for more information. Also, remember, go ahead and buy your zero emissions vehicle. Very important. I say that, and I don't even have one, which is bad. But anyway,
go
look
one.
At them. Let's go drive one. If I need
yeah.
a new car, that's what I'm going to get. Jose, thanks so much for being here. We appreciate it. Lots of great
Thank
information.
You, Alex.
Lots of great information.
We see it on the roads all of the time. Aggressive drivers tailgating, speeding, or swerving in and out of lanes. You've probably done a few of these yourself. Here to show us some of the warning signs and how to avoid aggressive drivers is Jose Plasencia with AAA in Clovis. Good morning, Jose.
Good morning, Amanda.
You know, we were just talking about it's raining outside.
Yes.
And sometimes people can get a little crazy driving, but you got to be careful. Because I want to talk about first the statistic when it comes to aggressive driving. You offered a very scary statistic. You want to talk about that?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, the AAA Foundation for Highway Safety did a survey, and we found that over 55.7% of all fatal crashes have to do with aggressive driving that may lead up to road rage.
So is road rage considered aggressive driving?
Not necessarily. Road rage is a criminal act which puts someone in danger on the road with a vehicle. So road rage may be a result of any one of these unsafe driving behaviors. And those unsafe driving behaviors include speeding, running red lights, failure to yield, racing, making it a contest mm-hmm. when you're actually in the car. Interestingly enough, speeding is a number one aggressive driving act. What that leads up to road rage.
We're going to take a look at some of those signs right now. We'll put those up on the screen. That way you can see if you have done any of these, if you take out your frustrations behind the wheel.
Yes.
And as you mentioned, speeding, obviously a big one, tailgating.
Yeah, yeah, that's one that actually if there's the top that actually engage other people to get upset at you, it is tailgating. And one really good best practice is stay at least 2 seconds behind the vehicle in front of you, especially on days like today's when it's raining. It also helps in your safety.
You know what, I gotta admit though, this is my biggest pet peeve because the law, you know, the law says you should, like you said, stay 2 seconds behind. So mm-hmm. that's about a car length behind.
That's correct.
But then you have all these people speeding up and getting into your little space.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And that can get annoying because it just makes you want to follow the other cars closer.
And that's a trap that a lot of motorists actually get into, is that they make driving or being on the road a contest. And we've got a lot of great tips in order to minimize that and don't become a victim of road rage or actually engage in aggressive driving. Mm-hmm. Because it comes down to this. Driving can be a very stressful situation, and all motorists actually get into a situation when they get frustrated behind the wheel. Mm-hmm. The trick is avoid aggressive driving, avoid running red lights, speeding, because ultimately what might happen is you might trigger someone else's negative response, and that might result in road rage.
Okay, and so here are some tips that you mm-hmm. offered us how to avoid those aggressive drivers. Like, don't offend or engage.
Actually, it's don't offend or engage.
Don't offend.
So offending may be accidental. For example, you might cut somebody off, and if you do, apologize. Wave, you know, mm-hmm. say, I'm sorry. Don't engage them. If you actually do get into an altercation, the best thing to do is drive away and do never get out of your car to settle any differences. Another one, of course, is avoid tailgating or honking your horn. And another one is avoid eye contact. And the reason why avoid eye contact is that if you are engaged with somebody who is exhibiting road rage, that focus, if you make eye contact and sometimes unfavorable gestures, will get you into even more trouble.
Like no finger.
Yes, of course.
That will make it worse.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
don't escalate.
Correct.
Don't make things worse by escalating. Got it.
Yeah.
Okay. And what should we do if we're confronted by an aggressive driver? What if we do all the, oh, I apologize, I didn't mean to, but what if that aggressive driver comes after us?
You know, that's a really great question. And what you've got to do is stay clear of these individuals. You should drive to a police station, a fire station, a very crowded place, and or call 911 if you find yourself in this situation. The fact of the matter is try not to engage an angry driver, because you cannot start a fight unless you are willing to be in it.
Do you think that people are at risk on the roads when it comes to road rage? Do you think they fear for their safety?
Well, you know what? That's a really great question. AAA Foundation for Highway Studies found that over 90% of all drivers feel that aggressive driving is a major threat to their safety on the road. And according to our statistics, over 50% of all fatal crashes actually are the result of aggressive driving and sometimes road rage.
Okay, so pretty much just stay calm, take your time, and I like the tip, leave plenty of time to get where you need to go, you know?
Yeah, yeah, don't try to make great time. Try to have a good time when in the vehicle. And that's one thing that we want to advocate at AAA, is not only safety and security on the asphalt, but safety and security on the road of life.
Okay, good tips. AAA also has a charity event coming up that you wanted to talk about, Jose.
Yeah, it's such an exciting thing that we're doing. We're partnering with the Junior Giants Community Fund, and we're going to have some great tailgates at our local district offices here, both in Clovis and in Fresno. And what's going to happen is that we're going to have hamburgers, hot dogs. We're going to have ball players from the Grizzlies teams, who are affiliated, of course, with the Giants, signing autographs in Fresno on April 17th from 11 to 2. We'll have the Grizzly players there signing autographs. We'll have hot dogs. We'll have vendors or our partners giving out discounts. On April 18th in Clovis here at 1595 Shaw Avenue, we'll have free hot dogs, hamburgers, and we're also going to have free child safety seat inspection. So if you haven't had your baby seat inspected in quite a while, and by the way, 90% of all child safety seats are installed incorrectly, come on by. We'll do it for free. You don't have to be a member.
That's a big one in the news lately.
Correct, correct. And another thing, if you come by and get a quote, we'll give up to $5 to the Junior Giants Fund to meet our goal of up to $50,000 that we want to give to the literacy program of the Junior Giants Community Fund.
That's great. Well, they can go to your office. Where your office is located?
The offices are located here in Clovis at 1595 Shaw Avenue, across from the Sierra Vista Mall, and also at 5040 North Forkner Avenue at West in Fresno. Come on in.
All right, or they can give you a call if they have any questions.
Absolutely.
323-3000, or go to their website, AAAFoundation.org. Thank you, Jose, for being here. Great tips.
Thank you very much, Amanda.
Stay tuned, everyone. More Central Valley Today right after this break.